Okay, in today's video, I am going to go over how to calculate and determine the resistance, the current, and the voltage for simple parallel circuits. Okay, this is the parallel circuit that we're going to use. It's the most common way a parallel circuit is drawn, but there is more than one way to draw them. The important thing to notice here is that the voltage source, our battery, and all of the resistors are parallel to each other, and they actually look like they're each parallel to each other, and that's the biggest hint that you have parallel components in a circuit. When they look like they're parallel and they're usually drawn correctly, then it's probably a parallel circuit. Okay? Now, these are the five things we're going to do. First, we're going to get the total voltage gain in the circuit. Then, we're going to get the equivalent resistance, or the total resistance, as I like to call it, in the circuit. Then, the third thing is we're going to get the total current to the circuit. Now, these are the things I like to call kind of the big three. We got to get these three things, these totals taken care of. Then we can figure out what the voltage drop is across each of the resistors. And then we can figure out what the current is through each of the three resistors. Now, this circuit has three resistors. All these rules apply whether you have two resistors, three resistors, four resistors, five. It does not matter. If you had only one resistor, it would actually be a series circuit. But if you have more than one resistor, then all these rules that we're going to talk about apply. And we're going to start with the total voltage in the circuit. This is the voltage gain. This is the battery. This is the thing that causes the electrons to gain energy or to get potential electric potential energy. There's only one of them, so it's pretty straightforward. The total voltage gain in the circuit is 20 volts. And I like to put down here V total because I know that's my total voltage gain. Okay, now we're going to do the equivalent resistance, and this is the tricky part. You remember, in series circuits, we just added them up. This would be 715 plus 12. You cannot do that in a parallel circuit. I know you want to, because that's the easy way out, but you have to use this scary-looking equation. Now, it's not that complicated, but yes, to figure out the equivalent resistance, you must use this equation. And this equation is simply not just adding them up. Okay, so let's go through. It's 1 over RT, which is the total resistance, equals 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. So we're simply just going to first plug the numbers in. Now, it's still just 1 over RT equals 1 over 7 ohms plus 1 over 15 plus 1 over 12 ohms. Now, pick up your calculator, and you can just punch these right into your calculator like this. Okay, it's just simply 1 divided by 7 plus 1 divided by 15 plus 1 divided by 12. And that will give you what 1 over RT equals 1 over RT, not RT. This is not the equivalent resistance. This is 1 over RT is equal to 0.293. Now, in order to get RT, I'm going to take the reciprocal of this side and the reciprocal of this side. If I take the reciprocal of this side, I just get RT. If I take the reciprocal of this side, I get 1 over 0.293. So in order to figure out what RT is, I have to do on my calculator 1 divided by 0.293. If I do 1 divided by 0.293, then I will get that the total resistance, the equivalent resistance of that circuit, is 3.41 ohms. Okay, so that's a little bit of math. It's not that complicated. Practice, figure it out, and you'll get the steps down. Now, let's get the total current. Once again, we're going to use Ohm's law. And in order to use Ohm's law, we're going to use the current. So we want to solve for I. I stands for the current. This is the voltage. This is the resistance. We're going to divide each side by R, and we're going to get that the total current, and I put down here IT, because it's the total, which is different than the current through each branch, and I want to make sure I keep those things separate from each other. The total current is simply the total voltage divided by the total resistance. Okay? If I use the total voltage and the total resistance, I'll get the total current. Okay? So, let's go through. IT equals the total voltage is 20, we determined. The total resistance is 3.41, and therefore the total current is 5.87 amps. Now we have the total voltage, the total resistance, and the total current, and those are the first big three things we needed to figure out for that circuit. Okay, now we can get the voltage drop. The voltage drop across each resistor. Now we need to think about parallel circuits. What is the voltage rule? The rule concerning the voltage drops. Well, we talked earlier that the rule is that the voltage drop across each resistor, 1, 2, and 3, is equal to the voltage gain from the battery. All right, so they're all equal to each other. Now, let me just point out and try and show you why. Let's look at this resistor. Between this resistor and the battery, there really are no elements in the circuit that are going to use any power or any energy. Yes, this one is kind of between it, but if you follow this resistor back to the battery, on both sides, back to the battery, okay? Just take your fingers and put it on the diagram. There's nothing between that resistor and the path back to the battery. So there's nothing that's going to use any of the energy that would be delivered to that resistor. Okay, if there was another resistor here, or here, or down below, then there would be something that would be using some of that energy. But there's nothing between any of these resistors. This one goes right back, this one goes right back. So they all get the full power from the battery, and that's why that works out like that. So if we want to know what the voltage drop is, the amount of energy used by resistor number one is just equal to the voltage from the battery, the total voltage, 20 volts. Okay, same thing for number two, and same thing for number three. They're each equal to the total voltage or the voltage from the battery. Okay, now that seems a little hard, but there, if you think about it, they're really all just connected right back to the battery. Okay, now we're going to go and do the fifth thing, which is the current through each resistor. Now we have to think about parallel circuits. What's the rule for the current? The current rule is that the current through each branch, through each resistor, branch 1, branch 2, branch 3, the current through each branch is going to equal the total. Now we said earlier the total is 5.87 amps. That's the current that comes out of this part of the circuit, comes out of the battery. Well, you have to kind of think about it a little bit conceptually. Right here at this point, we call this a node, and there's a split. Some of the current's going to go here, the remainder of the current's going to go here. There's another node right here. Some of the current is going to go this way, and some of the current is going to continue through, and they will actually all come back and add up. So the total current is the same here and here, but through the branches, it's going to be different. Now, the branches, there's three branches, they each get some of the current. So when we add them up, we get the total. Now, in order to calculate them, we're going to have to use Ohm's law again, and we're going to have to use those for the current. Now, we want to find the current through number one, so we have to get the voltage through number one and divide that by the resistance of number one. This resistance, not this resistance. That's why I like to write down I1, V1, R1. Okay, if you want I1, you have to use V1 and R1. V1 is 20 volts, same as the total, which we got from the previous slide. And this is R1 is 7, and that's 2.86 amps of current through that branch. Now we have I2. We're going to take V2, which is still 20, divided by R2, which is now 15, which is 15, and you get that the current through the second branch is 1.34. You'll notice the resistance is higher. This is 7, this is 15, so this is going to be less, okay? And this is about twice as high, so this is twice as less or half as much. Okay, now, the third one. Now, of course, this should say I3, but we have V3 and R3. V3 is 20. All the voltages drops are equal to the total. This is 12, the resistance of the third, 12 ohms, and you get 1.67 amps. All right, so there we have done all three currents, and let's look back at our rule. The current rule said these three currents should add up to the total. Well, let's see, 2.86 plus 1.34 plus 1.67, those equal 5.87. So if they all add up, then we know, we have a pretty good feeling we did that correctly. All right, so once again, We did the voltage, the resistance, and the current totals. Then we got the voltage across each resistor. Then we used the current rule to get the current through each resistor along with Ohm's law. Okay, so I know that's five steps. It's kind of a lot. The rules, the equations, write them all down. Follow the steps, plug the values in, get the answers with the correct units. Think about your thinking to see if you get everything in the right order, if everything makes sense. And I think you can do those problems no problem. Okay, thank you for watching. And if you enjoyed that video or found it helpful, please leave me a thumbs up or give me a comment in the comment section below. Thank you very much.